Welcome back to Charging Forward.
Today is April 22nd.
I cannot believe April is almost over.
Yeah, because before you know it.
It's gonna be May.
What was that?
What? That? Oh, it's nothing.
So as we were saying, next week, April is over.
Up.
Gonna be May.
There it is again.
I really don't see what you're talking about. I bet you should.
Tell me why.
Seriously.
What? We have updates to get to.
Okay, but I'm watching you.
This Wednesday, we have a big pack schedule.
Wednesday will be career day.
All students will have a chance to explore and learn about many different careers.
Your teachers will have the schedule for you this week.
And also on Wednesday is the Battle of the Books competition.
We are wishing our Battle of the Books team the best of luck.
Rio Plaza will take on students from schools all over the country on their knowledge of a certain book trivia.
Okay, go get them, Chargers. Represent Plaza and best of luck. Okay, before we move on, we have to discuss the thing from earlier.
What thing from earlier?
The music thing.
But
it's gonna be May.
Hey, you did it again.
I really don't know what you're talking about.
Fine, moving on.
Oh, and by the way, Friday will be a minimum day.
All right, moving on over to Adan for our lunches, and let's check out some birthdays.
And here are our 4-hour final full week of April lunches. We start the week with some nachos with cheese sauce on. And Tuesday, we are not playing the drums, but we will have a chicken drumstick for lunch. Don't be a chicken on Wednesday, for we are having a chicken sandwich. Thursday keeps the chicken train rolling with some rolled chicken taquitos. And on Friday, we have more chicken. Just kidding. Friday is homemade pizza. Well, those are your lunches for the week. Enjoy.
So today is a special day.
How so?
Well, today is Earth Day.
Earth Day? Isn't every day an Earth Day?
Technically yes, but like today is Earth Day.
I still don't get it.
You know what? Moises, can you enlighten us on this topic?
Well, today is Earth Day, and Earth Day is a day filled with events to increase the public awareness of all environmental problems with our Earth. Earth Day was first observed on April 22, 1970. It was the idea of a senator from Wisconsin who worked to bring more awareness to the environmental issues occurring to our Earth. The first Earth Day involved people from all over the USA as they marched, held rallies, and held educational programs. This surge in awareness for our globe did have some impact as the EPA was established in July 1970. The EPA, or Environmental Protection Agency, was established to regulate and enforce national pollution laws. The EPA and other agencies worked to curb pollution and help support our natural spaces. Earth Day has continued to be celebrated each year and is now a global celebration and action day. On this Earth Day, take a moment to pick up some trash or turn off lights when you are not in the room. Even little efforts can lead to a larger potential impact. Who knows, if we all continue to protect the Earth, it may just stay around for a very long time. We'll be right back. Last week, our field hockey team started up.
We're fielding 3 teams for field hockey.
Field hockey teams will be playing other schools from around the district.
Their games start on Tuesday, but here are the schedules for all the games for our teams.
Hopefully, we will see some of you out there for the games to cheer on your Chargers each week.
Also, in sports news, our Rocket League tournament is underway.
Multiple 4th and 5th grade teams have gone head-to-head in Rocket League each week during lunch.
Check out the Rocket League bracket in the cafeteria for the latest standings.
We will report more on the finals as they approach.
We wish the best of luck to all remaining teams.
Wow, a lot of sports to finish this year.
Hey, did you watch last week's episode?
Yeah, why?
What happened to Samaya's body?
No clue, but we should be careful. We can't have random heads reporting on the news.
This is true.
We may have had some warm springtime summer, like weather last week, but this week will cool down again. Expect mostly cloudy days for the week and low temps. Even though it is springtime, we have seen mostly cooler temps. There is a slight change of some rain early each morning, but it will mostly be a mist or sprinkle and not really true rain. I know I definitely enjoy these cooler temps in the mid-60s, but I look forward to the warmer summer months ahead. Like, it seemed like we have been stuck in our winter transition weather forever. Well, that is your Charger weather for this week.
Last week we held our annual color run. To say the colors were popping is an understatement. So many students were covered from head to toe with all colors of the rainbow. And I heard that we raised over $7,000. That means we get to make Mr. T, Mr. Romano, and Mr. Castile have red hair for a day. Or in some case, make them actually have hair for a day. And it also means we get to slime Mrs. Garcia. Oh, I cannot wait to see that gooey slime splash over her. It will be awesome. But anyway, here's a look back at some of the craziness from the event.
We'll be right back.
Well, another episode down.
Yeah, I feel like we forgot something.
Oh, well, we should remind people to buy their yearbooks.
Why is that?
Well, the window to lock in the 25 price is closing.
What do you mean?
It means you need to purchase a book either online or an order form before May 3rd to lock in the 25 costs before it goes up for the end of the year.
Ah, so what you're saying is we need to get our orders in because...
It's gonna be May.
Seriously?
What? I did nothing wrong.
Okay, let's get over with this.
Fine. So remember, everyone, get in those yearbook orders.
Good. And if you still need an order form, they can be picked up in the office.
And get them in because...
It's gonna be May.